Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi theme video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignertechtips.com. Well, we had a great question on one of our videos, and somebody says, do you know how to rotate the logo 360? Yeah, you can do it. It's a little overkill for me, but I'm sure some people might want to do it, and it probably worked better with a round one. We might try that in a minute. I'll show you how to do this. We've got to write a little bit of CSS to do this today, but don't let that put you off. Any CSS I'll write, I'll put below the video, and you're welcome to use it. All right, let's get started. First thing we want to do, we want to go to our theme customizer, and to get to the customizer, go down to your dashboard, go to appearance, and then customize. I've got mine open here, and let's go down to additional CSS at the bottom. And as you can see, I've taken away the CSS for this here. That one's not spinning. So let's just inspect it. I'm using the Google Chrome browser here with the great inspector tools. Most browsers have this nowadays, but if yours doesn't, Chrome is a free download. I'm going to right click and hit the inspect button. That's going to bring up our inspector panel here, and let's see what we've got. Here's the image. As you can see, as I'm rolling over it, it's actually highlighting it at the top, and it's popping. The image is actually popping up at the bottom here. Okay, and it's got an ID of logo. So let's start with that then. That's all we really need to know. And it's an ID. All IDs have to have a hashtag in front of them. Before I actually put this in, let's give it a title. It's a good idea to give things a title, especially if you write a lot of CSS. Makes things a lot easier to find, and it's also a courtesy if anybody else comes and edits the site after you. And to do a title, it's /**, and in between you can write your code. Anything in between the stars will not be written as, will not be read as code by the browser, so you can make notes in there and titles and things. So I'm going to say logo spin. Okay, let's drop down. And we know what it's called, and it's an ID, so it's hashtag logo, funnily enough. And let's open and close some curly brackets. And inside here, we've got to create an animation. So we're going to say animation, give it a name, give it whatever name you want. I'm going to call mine spin. And how long do we want it to take to spin or complete this action? I'm going to say 3 seconds. Obviously, you put in whatever time works for you. And I want it to sort of rotate around a straight line, so that'd be linear. And I want it to keep going and going and going, so that'd be infinite. Pop a little semicolon on the end. Now, I'm using the Chrome browser, so I need to copy this and do the same thing with the word WebKit in front of it. So if I drop down, write the word WebKit, -WebKit-, let's just copy this, paste it after the word WebKit right there, and that's gonna make it compatible with Chrome browser, which is what we need. Okay, so we've got the logo, the name, the actual timing of it, but now we need to tell it what spin needs to do. So let's drop down a little more, and we're going to say at keyframes, and the name of it, which is spin, or whatever name you gave yours, that comes next after keyframe. Now let's open and close some more curly brackets, drop down, and inside we can tell it what we actually want it to do. Now when it starts off, or at 0%, that's the start, what do we want it to do? Well, I want it to transform, I want it to start off right side up and then start turning around. So let's open some curly brackets here, and we'll say transform, colon, and we want it to rotate. And after the E, we want to open some round brackets and tell it how much we want it to rotate by. And when it starts off, I want it to rotate by 0 degrees. So it's going to start right side up, 0 degrees. Great. Now just after that little round bracket there, let's put a little semicolon. Now I'm going to copy this whole line, and when it completes, we've got to tell it what to do. So instead of typing it all out again, can do if you want to, I'm just going to copy it, drop down, and say at 100%, when it finishes, I want it to have rotated 360 degrees all the way around. And as you can see, it started doing that, and that doesn't work too well with this logo. But remember, we're using the Chrome browser here. So what I want to do is copy it and make it compatible with the Chrome browser. So let's make it compatible. I'm going to copy this. I'm going to drop down. I'm going to paste it just below. And after the at, I'm going to add our little WebKit again. Dash, WebKit, dash, keyframes. That should make it compatible. So we'll publish this. And like I said, that doesn't work with this. So let's do this. Let's make it rotate around the x-axis. So after each rotate, I'm going to put a capital X. There we go. And it's actually rotating around the x-axis there, which looks a lot better for that. So let's publish this. But if you were to put a round logo in, let's go ahead and put a round logo in there. So I'm going to go to theme options. So that's down to dashboard, Divi, theme options. Here's our logo. Let's upload a round logo. And let's set that one as the logo. And I want to mention while I'm in here, actually the first time I did this, this didn't work. And the reason was I had to clear the CSS cache. And to do that, again, go back down to Divi to theme options, go over to your builder, go over to your advanced tab, and usually static CSS file generation is switched to on. I hit the clear button, I turned it off, I saved my changes, and everything started working. So let's go back to our customizer and refresh and see if we've got that little round logo in there. There we go. And we've got our little round one. Now I can take those X's away there. If you don't want it to spin on that axis and just want to rotate it round and round. And we'll refresh. And as you can see, it's rotating round and round that way. Now, of course, if you wanted to spin it the other way, you could put a Y in there. Save this now and refresh again, and there you go, you've got it spinning the other way, around the other axis I should say. So I hope that's answered your question today. That's how to make your logo spin. Like I say, for me that's a little bit overkill, but if that's what you want to do, that's how to do it. Like I say, I'll put this code below the video. You're welcome to use it and modify it however you wish. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.